Tired of being in this press room and talking to you guys after games like this, but you know, they're a good team and a really good team at Frost. I thought defensively, you know, what we kind of do, our defense doesn't really prevent people from scoring, but it kind of plays some percentages and lets us hang around the games until we can get hot offensively. And I thought we kind of did that, but we definitely couldn't get hot offensively. It's probably the most stagnant we've played, and I think credit some of that to the Jacks defense. They play really good one-on-one. They seem to be able to help and recover. You know, most teams that help, it opens up a lot on the perimeter and around the basket, and they did a really good job flying around. But I felt like we were roaming around a lot on offense, which is tough when you don't have structure. You don't really have a go-to thing to do. So felt more that it was their defense versus our offense that really pulled the game away for them.
Coach, you know, obviously they're a little bit of a different team when they lose some of the players that they've lost this year, but Kerry Young in particular seems to have really been stepping up for them lately. Have you seen that, whether it's on film preparing for this or then today?
Yeah, Kerry scared us the most, especially because she's so good mid-range, and our defense kind of dares you to shoot that shot because I think, you know, it's hard to beat a team hitting a lot of mid-range jumpers. And again, maybe I'm just an offensive-minded guy, but I think if we can make some runs and hit some threes, that shot gets a little bit tougher. But she's really versatile, you know, and she didn't shoot well from three, but you have to respect her three-point shot, and she finds another way to get it done. So I thought, you know, the week or two after they lost Macy was, I'm sure AJ said, a little bit of a disaster, but you know, credit to them. They've done such a good job kind of rebranding what they do, and now they're still the team that we thought they'd be.
You did a good job, it seemed like, of forcing a lot of turnovers from them. Did it feel like maybe a little bit of a missed opportunity there in getting that many turnovers and maybe not capitalizing as much?
Yeah, a little bit. And I didn't think, I mean, I see we had 13 points off turnovers. It didn't seem like we were scoring off of them a ton unless we just get a run out. And again, a couple times we had really good plays. They'd block a shot at the basket or make a good challenge. But yeah, that's something we normally do. I mean, when you look at our offensive stats, a big part of that is that we create so many turnovers and get live ball turnovers with steals and can convert those into shots. But you know, when you're not shooting the ball well, it just changes everything because you're second guessing all your shots and it makes it a little easier on the defense. So I thought we had some really good looks for three in the first quarter when they didn't fall down. It hurt our mentality offensively.
How do you sort of see the race shaking out? It's about halfway through.
Yeah, I mean, I think the, you know, clear favorites are South Dakota State, but I think there's a heck of a lot of teams that can, you know, compete at that upper level, and there would be quite a run for the middle of the pack too. So, you know, I thought when we played IUPUI, they were really going to compete in the league, and I would say they slipped up at Omaha, but you know, they've played a tougher schedule, and that's. The fans back in Macomb are pretty excited, and I am too about our team. But I do have to remind people, you know, we hadn't played any games against either the South Dakota teams. We had to go to Oral Roberts still, you know, to North Dakota State, which is always a dangerous place to play. We've got IUPUI, Omaha at home. So, I mean, we've got some we kind of were the benefactor of, I think, a little lighter schedule early in the conference season. Now we're really going to see what we're made of.